Hey everybody, welcome back to the channel. Today we're going to be taking a look at Ubuntu 23.10 versus Ubuntu Unity 23.10. I'm just going to kick the installers off. Sign in. And on the Ubuntu side, online accounts, I'm going to skip that. Help improve, I'll say no to that one. Turn off location services. And ready to go. On the Unity side, I didn't really have that wizard to worry about. So now we will go with system updates. Alright, so 51 megabytes on the Ubuntu side and 241 kilobytes on the Unity side. So go ahead and install. Okay, now we're back. I'm gonna do a speed test on the restart. So we'll just type in shutdown R and then we'll put, what time is it, 9:37? So we wanna go for 9:38. And I'll do that on both sides. All right, and keep in mind, they're both fresh off of updates, so nothing's pending. Got about 10 seconds and it should restart. And it does look like Unity won. Alright, we'll take a look at the driver manager. And in Ubuntu, that's just called additional drivers. to the middle. And if you had an NVIDIA card, this is where you would enable the proprietary driver. And there's different versions that you can select from depending on which card you've got. All right, we'll take a look at System Monitor. Since Ubuntu Unity did not have the built-in GNOME System Monitor, I went ahead and downloaded the Plasma version. But the memory looks about the same, 1.4. And then the CPU, I saw it spike to 8.13 versus between 3 and 11. And now we'll take a look at HTOP. And it does need to be installed. We could choose to use the Debian edition, or we could go with the Snap. I guess we'll go with the Snap since we're dealing with Ubuntu. On each top. CPU, I've seen 3 to 5%. So CPU seems to be about the same. Memory, 990 megabytes on the Ubuntu side, 1 gig on the Ubuntu Unity side. All right, now let's take a look at the file manager. On the Unity side, we've got Nemo 5.8.4. And on the Ubuntu side, we have files, and it's the GNOME project 45.rc. And now we'll take a look at the system settings, and we'll touch on a few of them. We can start with appearance. You do see that under appearance, you can change your wallpaper. And on the Unity side, you can change your color. So if we didn't want purple, let's say we wanted to go blue, change that there. And now when we click on things, it should have a highlight of blue now. Yeah, we can see the icons have changed. The appearance icon is now blue. All right, if we want to go to displays, we can change your resolution, your refresh rate, and then about to where that's going to be under details on the Unity side. And then if we go to system details on the Ubuntu side, that gives us more information. Ubuntu is running Wayland, to where Unity is running... we'll have to check the Unity side here in a minute. But I believe Unity is running X11. I don't know that Unity supports Wayland yet. And I just opened Terminal and did a login CTL on both, just to see what compositor we were using. On Ubuntu, we've got Wayland. On Ubuntu Unity, we've got X11. And let's take a look at what Firefox version we've got. Let's go help about. And we are running 118.0.1. And those are both the Snap version for Ubuntu. All right, let's look at the software manager. Ubuntu Unity, it's called the Synaptic Package Manager. And over here on Ubuntu, it's just the new app center that's built on Flutter. So if we wanted to pull up an application like Inkscape, if I could spell. And then I'll do the same thing on the Synaptic Package Manager. So when we click on it, we can see the differences here. We would be getting 1.2.2, to where on the Ubuntu store, we'd be getting 1.3.1, which is a bit newer. And for the Synaptic Package Manager, we would have to mark it for install. It'd show us the dependencies, we'd mark it. And then it's basically in our queue to be updated. To apply that, we just click the apply button. To where on Ubuntu, we just hit install. And now we'll take a look at the system trays. We've got our power button, about this computer and system settings. About this computer is just a quick link to the details panel. We could lock the machine, our profile, log out, suspend and shut down. And then we've got our time with the calendar, volume button, keyboard layout, network, notifications, and then our theme switcher where we can change colors. And on the Ubuntu side, we've got our power, lock, settings, screenshot, volume, network, power mode, nightlight, and we can switch between dark and light. So it's basically the basic GNOME system tray. And next we'll take a look at NeoFetch. They're running the same kernel. The Unity side has about 400 more packages installed by default. Same bash. Desktop environments are different. Unity, of course, is Unity 7.7. Ubuntu is GNOME 45.1. Ubuntu's running right at a gig, and so is Unity. And Ubuntu Unity and Ubuntu, they share the same release cycle. I'm comparing version 23.10, which is an interim release, and 24.04 is releasing in April of next year. All right, next we'll look at the tweak tool. On the Unity side, it came with its own Unity tweak tool. On the Ubuntu side, I went and downloaded the GNOME tweaks. So we'll pull that up. And here's where you can go in and change things like your cursor, fonts. Go in here and make sure that the subpixel selected for LCD screens, and you can change full hinting. And on the Unity side, this is what that would look like. So hinting would get full. There's something I want to show you guys. So if you're coming from Linux Mint, and you like the cursor that it comes with, this is how you can get that. So let's just go download it on each. And it is called the Bibeta cursor. And you don't have to download this one. This is just for an example. I like the way it looks, so I'll show you the way this one looks in the example. Modern classic. And then we'll scroll down. It gives us the install directions. This is what we want here. So let's pull up a terminal. And we will CD into our download, which is where we downloaded the file to. And we just want to extract that. And then we will move it to our user share icons folder. Make sure you put a space in that or you'll get an error message like I did. Okay, now let's close down the Unity tweak tool and we'll go back into it. And now we see Bibeta, Modern Classic, and you can tell our cursor has changed. So we'll just do the same thing over here on the Ubuntu side. Close that out. Pull up a terminal. it's basically the same thing, right? Window tar, XBF, beta. And then I tab to finish the name out just to speed it up. And then we'll go sudo move beta star, and put that in our user share icons. Confirm, and then we'll ls to list everything. We see it is empty now. So if we go back into tweaks, and we go to appearance, cursor, should have our by beta. Yeah, there it is, modern classic. And you can see it's changed. So just something real quick. They both have a tweak tool. On the Ubuntu side, I had to download that to get it to work. And it's still basically the same functionality. All right, let's take a look at the wallpapers. Right click, change desktop background. And then on Ubuntu, right click, change background. I would suspect that the Unity side has its own wallpaper. Yeah, that one's unique to Unity. So if we minimize this, it's got a little bool. See what else is different. Yep, and there's the Unity specific one. Let's see what the Ubuntu one looks like. It's purple and orange. Yeah, I'll stick with those two. Pretty colorful. And I wanted to take a second to just talk about Ubuntu Unity in case someone hadn't ever heard of it before. Ubuntu Unity is a Linux distribution based on Ubuntu, using the Unity interface in place of the GNOME shell. The first release was version 20.04 LTS on May 7th, 2020. Prior to the initial release, it had working names of UnUbuntu and Ubuntu Unity Remix. The Unity interface was originally developed by Canonical and first included as the default interface in Ubuntu 11.04, which was released April 2011. Unity was developed as an alternative to the GNOME shell, which replaced GNOME 2 interface. At the time, Canonical had planned to converge the desktop, cell phone, and tablet interfaces into Unity 8, a project that was abandoned in 2017 when Ubuntu moved back to GNOME 3. And that's going to do it for today's video. I hope you found the video helpful and informative. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them in the comment section below. Also, please don't forget to like and subscribe. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.